Good afternoon, everyone. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the first formal presentation of the Bun Box. And the bits and pieces I've seen are a real treat this afternoon. So we'd like you to sit back and relax. Just out of courtesy, can we make sure phones are silenced, please? Just courtesy to the children and the work that's put into this. Also, if we need to evacuate the building, you'll notice there are three exits down either side, and there are a couple at the back. So I feel like Ed was in here. You have a light, no, you don't have a light vest under your chairs. Also, please, if you could refrain from standing in your seat and take photos, in fairness to other people. There's opportunity at the back there, but please, not in front of any of the barred areas there. We've got video cameras and light vests with you. Have a great afternoon. I'm certainly looking forward to seeing the full extent of the show. Thank you.
Very, 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 very funny. Help Grandma pick them up, then.
Hey, we've got some great buns here. This one looks like it's made of gold. When Mum was little, didn't you tell her the stories? All about buttons in a button box?
Yes, I did.
Is this the same button box?
Are these the same buttons?
Can you tell us the stories?
Oh, I can't remember all of those stories now. Anyway, I've got to go and get tea ready.
Whales?
was your great-great-uncle.
He was really great, double great.
Granddad, your jokes are so bad.
Hey, look, this was Uncle Jack's.
It's not a button, it's a pebble.
But Jack was going to make his little button. He never did, obviously.
It's what little dots painted on.
It's an Aboriginal painting from Australia.
Australia?
Uncle Jack's dad was an Aborigine people in the desert near Ayers Rock. They told them their legend about how the world began.
Of the
boasting is bad. I never boast.
Now, Nick Jack, Alice never boasts.
It's okay, Granddad. Just ignore him. Hey, Grandma, we've got some lovely shiny sequins in here. I think these are Granddad's pajamas.
Actually, that's right. They got my gold satin ones.
Ooh, nice.
Not really.
Didn't you sew sequins on a costume for the boy next door?
Yes, I did. He wasn't there. They appeared on TV once.
Hang on, I've got the record somewhere. Here it is. Fatty Fat Fat Man. That's him.
Fat Man?
Yes, it was a silly name, and he was no fattening stick insect.
He didn't eat too many biscuits unlike some people.
Sometimes you just gotta button your lip.
play our hero.
Find one.
Breton. He fought in France near the River Normandy in 1940, and he carved this button for his sweetheart, Emily.
Look, the A and the T are interlinked.
So was your uncle taught in Europe? Did he eat beetles and stuff?
Well, he fought in France in near Normandy. Have you still got those postcards yet?
What postcards?
On the 5th of June 1944, Emily and Tom sent each other a postcard. Turned out to be the last one they ever wrote, sadly.
Why?
Because the very next day there was a dreadful battle. The Battle of the Normandy. Uncle Tom never came back, sadly.
How awful.
Here are the postcards of this old locket with Emily's.
This one's from Emily. June 5th, 1944.
Wow, look at Tom's writing. How neat is that?
Here they are in Emily's locket.
They look so much younger than I imagined.
Thank you.
to fight with great confidence and growing strength in the air, which will defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
Thank you.
anthropologist. He studied the people of the Serengeti.
Thank you. to get this story on presentational inspirational celebration.
Bombay.
tell them about this reindeer.
Oh, child of my old friend,
lovely cup of tea.
Don't I keep one, Pete?
No, I'm teaching you a lesson.
I'll go get one myself.
Black button comes from Gambler's army D-mob suit.
D-mob suit?
With a thin moustache and white lip pads, he looks like Zoot the suit.
Zoot the suit?
But this one here is a strange one again. It belonged to Auntie Nellie.
And it's got no buttonholes.
Oh no, she wore it in her belly.
Auntie Nellie in her belly?
She was a dancer of repute in her oriental way. And when she wore her belly button, she would often say, Penny told me that it belonged to a leprechaun. who was grumpy because he wanted it back. Because it was a magic button that showed the way to the end of the rainbow.
Yeah.